Using filters in Excel can help you sift through data that can otherwise seem overwhelming. It works by listing all the available items within the column that you're filtering and then allowing you to select only those that you want to see.
And before we start, it's important to know that this does not delete any data, it only hides the data. For example, let's say we need to filter the sales data. You'll find the filter options in the Data tab in the Sort and Filter section. You can quickly add filters by placing your cursor anywhere on your data and then clicking the filter button. Excel will do its best to determine what data it is that you want to apply the filter to and then place filtering drop-down menus off the top row of your data. It assumes that the top row contains your data headers. Just be aware that this may not always work correctly. So while Excel does not have a problem with blank cells, if it finds an entire portion of a column or row that is blank within the data, it will assume that this is the end of your data set and exclude any other rows or columns. So take a look. Notice that when I did this, no filter buttons were applied to the product and sales column. And if we look at the associate names that we can filter for, Henry is missing from the options. So this is because of the blank column and row that separates these. So let's click the filter button again to remove the filters. So to fix this, we can manually select all the cells that we want to include and then click filter. So again, remember that filtering works by listing all available items in the column you're filtering and hiding the rest. So let's say that we want to filter for only Jamie's sales results. In the associate column, we would need to uncheck select all and then click to select Jamie. So this hides all of the rows except for the ones labeled for Jamie. And you can tell that they're hidden by looking on the row numbers and notice how it goes from row 1 to row 8, 9, and then 20. And the other data is just hidden in the rows that we can't see. And because this other data is now hidden, it is also removed from the filter options in the other columns. Notice if we look at the filter option for the dates column, we can only select to filter January and February because they're the only two options that are currently displayed. So let's click on clear to display everything again. When it comes to values, you have additional filtering options available. If you're filtering dates, for example, you can select from the options in the date filters and choose from a specific date, a range of dates, or any of these other preset options. You have similar options when working with other number data. Select your number filters, and here you'll find other preset options that you can select from. But regardless of the data type, you can also filter by the color of the cell and by the color of the font used. For example, we can filter this to display only the cells highlighted in yellow or only entries in red font. For more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.